If you want to fast track your Google Tag Manager knowledge and skills, you're in the right place. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to set up and use GTM to streamline the management of your tags. We'll cover important terminology along the way and walk through the steps to add Google Analytics to your website. Stay tuned until the end for a short quiz to test your knowledge. Google Tag Manager lets you manage all of your marketing and analytics tags in one place. It acts as a layer between your website and the different platforms you're using. It also allows you to streamline the management of the different tags you are using. Okay, let's start by heading to the Google Marketing Platform site. This is the Google Marketing Platform site. You can find it by navigating to marketingplatform.google.com. I've also included a link in the description below this video. This is where you can sign up for Google Tag Manager. To do this, let's hover over For Small Businesses and select Tag Manager. Then on the top right corner, we can see there are two options. If you already have a Google Tag Manager account, you can sign in. Or if you're just getting started for the first time, then we can click Start for Free to create your account. Since I already have a Google Tag Manager account, I'm going to select Sign in to Tag Manager. Now we need to log in using our Google account. This can be your Gmail address, your Google Workspace address, or the login details you use to access other Google products. Since I already have an account, we can see we're looking at a list of existing accounts. If you're getting started for the first time, then you won't see any accounts. You'll be immediately prompted to create a new Google Tag Manager account. To do this, let's click Create Account at the top. These are also the steps you'll need to complete if you're getting started for the first time. You need to name your account. You can think of your Google Tag Manager account as a folder. It will be used to store everything at a top level. Generally, you'll want a separate account for each separate business you're managing. Once we've named our account or top level folder, we need to select our country and choose if we want to share anonymous data with Google. Then we need to name our container. A container is used to store all of the tags, logic, and other information you configure for your website. You can name your container anything you like, but I suggest something that makes it easy to identify the website you're going to install it on. Next, we need to select where we will be using Google Tag Manager. We're going to install GTM on our website, so let's select Web. However, you can see there are other options. So if you're looking to install GTM on an app, accelerated mobile page, or on a server, you can choose one of these. Now let's click Create. Our new account and container has been created, and we're now given two pieces of code. The first one is the most important. This is the JavaScript container code, and you will need to add this to all of the pages of your website. When we add Google Tag Manager to our website, we're adding this code. This code should be placed inside the head tag on your website, and ideally should be one of the first things in your head tag. The second piece of code is the NoScript version of the container. This will load if someone has JavaScript disabled. Since almost all of the tags we use in Google Tag Manager are JavaScript, this won't improve the accuracy of the data we collect. So if you can't add this extra NoScript code to your website, it won't have a major impact. Let's close this. And let's copy the container ID. This is at the top and starts with GTM and then a dash. Now it's time to add the code to our website. There are different ways you can add the container code, depending on how you've created your website. For example, if you're using WordPress, then you can use a plugin to add the container to all of your pages. Let's head to WordPress to take a look. This is the GTM for WordPress plugin. It's just one of the plugins you can use to add the container code to all of the pages on your WordPress site. To add Google Tag Manager, let's install the plugin. And let's activate the plugin. Let's select Settings. Now we need to paste our container ID. There are additional settings you can adjust in the GTM for WordPress plugin, but we're going to leave these for now. And let's click Save Changes. For some reason, the plugin has saved our container ID, but the container code option is set to off. So let's change this to on. And let's click Save Changes again. Our Google Tag Manager container has been added to all of the pages of our WordPress site. If you're using a different website platform, then I recommend searching the support documentation for your platform provider. And if you're using Squarespace, Shopify, or WooCommerce, I've included links to extra tutorials in the description below this video. Okay, now that we've added Google Tag Manager to our website, it's time to configure our first tags. Let's head to Google Tag Manager. We're going to start by adding Google Analytics to our website, so let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Tag GA4 Page View. And let's select Tag Configuration. We're going to start by selecting Google Tag as the tag type. The Google Tag lets us send data to Google Analytics using our GA4 measurement ID. In this video, we're just going to focus on adding the tag, but if you'd like to learn more about GA4, then I've included a link in the extra resources in the description below this video. Now we need to get our measurement ID, so let's head to Google Analytics. I've already navigated to Admin, and then we need to select Data Streams, or we can select Data Collection and Modification on the left, and then choose Data Streams. Now we select the data stream for our website. You can now copy the measurement ID for your data stream on the top right corner. And now we can head back to Google Tag Manager. You can paste the measurement ID under Tag ID, but we're going to create a variable so that we can reuse the measurement ID across multiple tags. This also means if you ever need to change the measurement ID, you can just update it in one place. So let's click the variable icon under Tag ID. Now let's click the plus sign on the top right corner. Let's name the variable GA4 measurement ID. Select Variable Configuration and choose Constant as the variable type. Now let's paste our measurement ID as the value and let's click Save. Now we need to select a trigger for our tag. We're going to select the Initialization All Pages trigger. This will fire our tag on all of the pages of our website before any other tags, apart from any tags used for consent. For example, if you have a cookie banner on your website, then this should be triggered before the Google tag. So using the Initialization All Pages trigger will mean we can report on all of the pages people are viewing on our website. If you have users from Europe, you should also take time to configure a consent management platform to add a cookie banner to your website. If this applies to your business and website, I've included a link to my dedicated tutorial covering this in the description below this video. Okay, now that we've configured our tag and added a trigger, let's save the tag. Before we publish this tag to our live website, the next step is to preview and test our changes. So let's click Preview on the top right corner. A new tab opens for Tag Assistant. To use Tag Assistant, you will need to ensure that you've added the Google Tag Manager container code to all of the pages on your site. Since I've already installed the container on my demo website, I'm going to enter the URL. Now let's click Connect. Another tab opens with the URL we entered. Our website loads. And we can see on the bottom right corner that we're connected to Tag Assistant. This means we can now browse our website and complete other actions to test our tags, triggers, and variables. Let's navigate to one more page. Now let's open Tag Assistant. At the top, we can see our Google Tag Manager container ID is selected, and this lets us view the tags that did and didn't fire from our container. We can see our Google Analytics tag has fired twice to track the two pages we viewed. Apart from viewing details for our GTM container, we can also select the GAForm measurement ID at the top. This lets us view all of the events that have been sent to Google Analytics. Since Google Analytics includes built-in automatic tracking called Enhanced Measurement, we can see additional events have been sent along with the page view events. If you would like to learn more about these automatic events and GA4, please take a moment to check out the extra resources in the description below this video. Okay, now since our Google Analytics tag is firing correctly, it's time to publish our container. Let's head back to Google Tag Manager to do this. It's important to highlight that if you already have Google Analytics installed on your website, you will want to remove this at the same time you publish your changes. Otherwise, you will have the tag from Google Tag Manager and your existing Google Analytics tag on your website. So two identical tags, which isn't good. Since I don't already have Google Analytics installed on my website, let's click Submit. We name the version. This should be something short that makes it easy to identify the changes you've made in case you ever need to revert to a previous version. You can also enter an optional description. When you're ready, click Publish. We've now published our container. This means the Google Analytics tag has now been added to our live website. You've successfully added your first tag to your website using Google Tag Manager, and you understand some of the most important terminology, including tags, triggers, variables, and more. Are you ready to test your Google Tag Manager knowledge? You can find a link to my Google Tag Manager quiz in the description below this video. And if you'd like to learn more about Google Tag Manager, please take a moment to check out my course and other tutorials on YouTube. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.